إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, we begin with the praises that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His assistance, and we beg for our forgiveness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evil of our own selves and from the evil of our sins and its consequences. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides to the straight path, then none can misguide him from that path. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to lead astray, then none can guide him to the straight path. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and final messenger. فَعَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O you who believe, fear Allah the way He is supposed to be feared, and do not die unless you are in a state of Islam. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً ۚ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ ۚ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. O mankind, fear Allah who created you from a single person, and from him his wife, and from them both He created many men and many women, and fear Allah again through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not break off your relations with your close relatives, for verily Allah is ever watchful over you. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. O you who believe, fear Allah and always speak the truth. He will direct you to do good deeds and will forgive you your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will achieve success in this life and in the hereafter. Amma ba'd, as for what follows, ittaqu Allah wa'alamu, fear Allah and know, inna khayr al-hadith kitab Allah wa khayr al-hadi hadi Muhammad al-Nabiyyin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech is the most truthful and the best of all speeches, and the guidance of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best and the most perfect of all guidance, who said, the worst of all matters are those that are innovated in this deen. And every single innovation is a misguidance, is an error. And all errors lead its people to the fire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah protect us from it. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Respected elders, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, after the opening khutbah, I would like to recite three beautiful verses from the Quran, which will probably be the focus of our khutbah. The choice between two things, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran in Surah Shams. Shams means sun. Sun is something that gives light, subhanAllah. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throws light on two fascinating points. And that is what we take from ayah number 8, 9 and 10. Allah says, فَأَلْحَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَهَا مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this glorious ayats, that Allah has showed insan, Allah has shown man two parts, the part of goodness and the part of evil. Whoever chooses the part of goodness will be successful. Whoever chooses the part of evil, whoever chooses the path of goodness will be successful, and whoever chooses the path of evil will be destroyed or will be in destruction. Brothers and sisters, three points from this ayat. Allah has given us so much of intelligence, knowledge, that you and I both know what is right and what is wrong. Second, when you choose the path of success, Allah will give you success. When you choose the path of destruction, surely you and I will be bound to be destructed sometime or the other. And today, insan, man, it has indulges himself that in things that brings him benefit and brings evil as well. And if you look in our lives, about 90% of our lives, be it anything, every single thing has some good in it and has some evil in it. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in an authentic hadith collected by Imam Ibn Majah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, احرس على ما ينفعك احرس على ما ينفعك. Strive, be persistent, be consistent in what benefits you. ينفعك comes from the word نفع. نفع means profit. What benefits you, what brings you profit, strive for it. Subhanallah. And brothers and sisters, today technology has some good uses and has some bad uses. And today, whatever technology may be, whatever form it may be, it has become an integral part of our life, whether you like it or not. Subhanallah, whether you like it or not, it has become a part of our life. To make things easier, to make things simpler. But subhanallah, as every single year that passes by, phones become smarter, while we become dumber. Subhanallah. With that, I introduce the Jumu'ah Khutbah of this afternoon. Smartphones, not really smart enough. Inshallah, this khutbah will focus on four main things. Number one, the advantages, the benefits that smartphones bring us. Number two, the disadvantages. Number three, the evils in it. And number four, as good Muslims, what is our duty towards it? When you and I use it, inshallah ta'ala. With that, let's move to our first heading. Number one, what are its benefits? You can list out many, but here are just five things that I could put down in this short khutbah. Number one, the greatest thing that smartphones do is they connect people, subhanallah. They bring a great network in terms of business, in terms of relations, in terms of friends, in terms of anything you want. Smartphones today have the best way to connect to people all across the globe, subhanallah. That's number one. Number two, today with these smartphones in our hands, we have access to knowledge that, subhanallah, some of the greatest ulama probably 100 years back didn't have access to. Why? They couldn't search a Bukhari, they couldn't search a Sahih Muslim, they couldn't search a Quran using one simple tag or word. You and I can do it, subhanallah. Go to any Quranic website, go to any hadith, just write the word rent, write the word horse. It will pick up all the hadith with horse, subhanallah. How could the ulama 100 years back do it? You and I have access to it, amazing, subhanallah. That's what smartphones do. Number three, you and I can follow ulama, you and I can follow scholars and their sayings. You and I can follow big personalities that you want to stay connected with. Number four, subhanallah, current affairs. Everything is on our fingertips. News briefs, they come as pop-ups. You don't have to even watch television at 9 o'clock to see the latest news. Everything is popped up on our phones. And number five, subhanallah, you and I can share good private moments with our close family members, right? All these things are benefits that a smartphone brings. But now let's look at some disadvantages that the smartphone brings. Allahu Akbar. Now I have two things. Number one, disadvantages. Number two, evils. And you will actually know what they are, how different they are. Understand, disadvantages is pertaining to your life and to the phone that you use. Evils from the smartphone is how the society is affected. And this is what I want to focus between disadvantages and evils, inshallah. The disadvantages, number one, Allahu Akbar, addiction of use. It's just become, we are now drug addicts. Trust me, subhanAllah, you and I can't do without a phone. You want to really torture somebody? SubhanAllah, keep his phone away for 2 hours. He'll go into depression. This is how much you and I are addicted to our smartphone today. SubhanAllah. Number two, smartphones today use up our time so much that by Allah, I'm telling you, you and I don't have time for our kids today. You walk into your house from your offices, the first thing is your 7-year-old son or your 9-year-old daughter is jumping to play with you, and you don't have time for it. I don't have time for it. Allahu Akbar. This khutbah is for myself before I tell you. We just push away our kids. Why? Because we have some messages, WhatsApp, Facebooking, whatever you want to do. SubhanAllah, it's quality time that you are missing out on your kids. Like the old saying goes, you spend time with kids when they are kids, they will spend time when you are adults, or rather at old age. They will spend time with you when you need them. Spend that quality time. Number three, SubhanAllah, it's like cancer. Selfie obsession. Allahu Akbar. If you can get an access to a lady's cell phone, SubhanAllah, they won't have so many contacts, then they will have so many pictures of themselves. That's called selfie obsession. Understand, brothers, this is nothing but trying to misuse what Allah has given as mercy and as rahmah. Every single angle that you can take, think of, there's a picture in it. Every single thing. And the worst thing is you and I post it on Facebook. Give access to boys. Give access to non-mahrams. Give access to people who don't even know you. They are looking at your profile pic. They are looking at your display pic. Whatever, they are looking at your personal stuff. The greatest disadvantage is selfie obsession. Next, the worst thing that sometimes people with knowledge do, unfortunately, they get into useless debates. Right? You have a group of probably about 100 people, SubhanAllah. Initially WhatsApp had limited people, and now they've gone up to 250 people or more probably. And the more you add, the more questions come in. And SubhanAllah, every person in that group is an alim by himself. The fatwas they post. One question, brother, should I take riba from the bank? And you have 10 answers for it, 10 answers against it. And there's a big debate. And you know what time the debate happens? Allahu Akbar. I'm still trying to get up for Qiyamul Layl all my life. And the best part is when you get up for Fajr and see, from 1 to 4 people are debating. Allahu Akbar. What a time you have spent on the stupid phone rather than spending time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Time during Qiyamul Layl today is being time for debates, for uploading stuff, for WhatsApping, Facebooking, disgusting stuff that you and I are doing in the night rather than at least sleeping. Allah says in Surah Naba, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. Allah has created the night so that you can rest. SubhanAllah. We've just flipped that ayat. We've just flipped that ayat today. How many misuses of WhatsApp and Facebooking? Why in the midnight? Just because you have better speed? Allahu Akbar. Think again. There are much more useful things that you can do with it. And number five that I want to discuss is spreading of fake news. SubhanAllah. The amount of blood that I could have given through WhatsApp, I would have probably finished all my blood till now. Right? The amount of blood people ask. SubhanAllah. Every single day you have some fake messages going across. And then the worst thing is you have even shirk coming up. You have some vague message or fake message saying if you don't spread this to 10 people, tomorrow something will happen to you. And what do? Right then you spread. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah 49, ayah number 6, verify every single news, lest you should spread it and regret out of ignorance. Allah says in the Quran, verify it. Now I come to the evils of smartphones. And this is what I want you to pay attention to, brothers and sisters. It's just about 3-4 minutes that I would take. But I want you to pay attention to the evils that the smartphones brings to the society, or rather to our own family members. Allah. Number one, smartphones have started open pornography. That's the biggest destruction to our ummah today. Open pornography. And if you know something about pornography, subhanAllah, the income of Bill Gates would shy off. The income of any top company, the income of Apple would shy off. The income of any top company would shy off from the income generated from pornography. Allahu Akbar. Two leading industries, pornography and cosmetics. And we are not bad, we are not far from it. Probably we are 50% donors to that income. Allahu Akbar. Pornography is the greatest evil that smartphones spread. Today, it's accessed on fingertips. Fingertips, and it's just gone even vulgar by the day. Allahu Akbar. Even vulgar by the day. Number two, brothers, understand, it's destroying families. It's destroying families. How is it destroying families? Number one, parents don't have quality time for their kids. Don't have quality time for the kids. And I discussed this in the disadvantages, but I want to get it again. Why? Because today the mothers are involved in Facebooking. The dads are involved in Facebooking. And how are the children getting affected? SubhanAllah. You and I, probably all of us sitting here, 25 years back, you and I know that we spent more time on the field than books. Right? You and I spent more physical activity. Today, the kids don't spend time physically or outdoor. They spend time more on iPads and iPhones. Right? Alhamdulillah, I gave a khutbah last year on the third parent, how the iPhones are replacing parents today. Why? I'm busy. Push off my child with an iPhone or an iPad. That time that he wants from me, I give it to him through an iPad or an iPhone. What's he learning? SubhanAllah. You have access to YouTube for him. You have access to every single filth. And what time? When he wants you. Mothers, Allahu Akbar, mothers are neglecting. So many cases. We are seeing that mothers are neglecting children's duties. Why? Because of smartphones. Because they don't have time. Because they're more involved in Facebook or WhatsApp or YouTube. Spouses are having problems. Why? SubhanAllah. I have to bring this in today's khutbah. Let's not shy off. And I'll tell you something personally, what happened to me in a couple of weeks back. There are about more than 3-4 cases that came to me personally. By Allah, I'm not lying. What does Facebook do? SubhanAllah. It gets your past to the present. And this is a reality. I have so many sisters coming to me and saying, brother, somehow my husband, through this smartphone, contacted or came friends with his old crush. Now you all know what crush is. And they used to go around in college. She's married, my husband's married, we have kids. Now the problem is they want to get married again. SubhanAllah. Brothers, this is haram, this is zina, this is what is destroying families. By Allah, this is what is destroying families. SubhanAllah. When I heard this, I was shocked. I said, how can you and I go back, think of our old times and say, okay, I want to contact this girl or this boy. Brothers, it's destroying families today. By Allah, you and I are a witness. There are so many divorce cases in our own community. Forget others. Today, the Institute of Marriage is crumbling. Why? Because of these stupid things. SubhanAllah, brothers, why go back. You've done filth, I've done filth, let's leave it in the past. Let's look for a better life that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do you even have to go back and think that I want to be? And the best part, brothers, the best part is you have 100 people poking you as friends, 100 men, you don't respond. One good female, and subhanallah, you just don't want to poke, you want to do everything. Allahu Akbar. Understand, this is what shaitan plays. This is how shaitan plays. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nisa, man is weak in terms of sex. Man is weak, Allah is created. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانَ ضَعِيفًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created man in terms of, weak in terms of women. And the fact, and the proof is the smartphones. Subhanallah. The greatest destruction today is causing, there is no barakah in the house. There is no barakah between a husband and wife. There is no barakah between children and parents. The worst thing that a father and a son can do is buy a smartphone at the age of 10, 12 and 14. Subhanallah. You're killing that child, parents. By Allah, you're killing that child. You're giving access to boys, you're giving access to girls, you're giving access to internet, you're giving access to pornography. And then at 17 and 18, you come to an alim and say, my child is lost, my child is gone, I just can't get him back. He doesn't even pray Fajr. Who was responsible to give that in the first place? That she or he spent all night chatting with boys, chatting with girls. And then at the age of 18, you want them to come for Fajr? Subhanallah, think again. Parents, you are responsible for that fitna that you have got in your house. There's an age, there's a limit for everything. Allah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, train your child at the age of 7 for salah. 3 years, he's given training. When do we train our child for salah? Never. Never. Brothers, understand, you and I need to go back to the Quran and Sunnah and understand the ways of Rasul. Think for yourself, would Rasulullah give a smartphone to his daughter, to his son at the age of 14? Is it necessary, brothers? Think again. Keep your worldly wealth to yourself. Or rather, that 50,000 rupees that a smartphone costs, spend it in a masjid. But don't spoil your child, don't spoil your daughter, and then come crying. Saying that I've lost everything. My son doesn't listen to me. My daughter doesn't listen to me. Brothers, today is the age of fitna. By Allah, it's the age of fitna. We see so many crimes only based on photographs. Sisters take their pictures and upload it. Subhanallah. You don't even know they are being sold. Your face is being sold to a pornography website. Brothers, understand, these are crimes that are happening. Look into it and restrain yourself. I'll end my talk with a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said that during the time of Qiyamah, zina will be open. Zina will be made open. And by Allah, today zina is open through our smartphones. Our eyes are committing zina when we watch them. Our words, our tongues are committing zina when we say that she is gorgeous, you're beautiful. Our fingers are committing zina when we type texts. And by Allah, Allah's Rasul says that there will come a time when your private parts will commit zina and they will bear witness against you. That's the time of today, brothers. Yes, our ummah is suffering. Let us take hold, let us take control. Subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa Allahu Akbar. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah wa lakum wa li sa'il al-muslimin fa astaghfiruhu innahu ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون We begin with the praises of the Lord of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his beloved family members, upon his beloved companions, and upon all of us and our family members. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. I open with an ayah of Surah Hashr, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, fear Allah, first fear Allah, and then strive towards earning something. Strive towards a day that you have to stand before Allah. Strive towards it. Back your bags in such a way that when you stand before Allah, you will be happy of what you did, of what you left behind in this world, and fear Allah again. And surely Allah knows every single thing about what you did. Brothers and sisters, in the second Jumu'ah Khutbah, I want to focus on what you and I can do as Muslims. You and I are stuck with this, and inshallah it only grow. But as good Muslims, you and I can make use of it in our lives. The money, the 50,000, the 60,000 bucks that you and I spend on these gadgets, you can make it as means of creating a better akhirah for yourself. You can make it a means of something called a sadaqatul jariyah. How is it sadaqatul jariyah? When you can have apps that you can actually learn knowledge, subhanAllah, learn and spread knowledge. Fear Allah in whatever you do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fear Allah in whatever you do. Number three, use it to seek Allah's pleasure. Then you can use it to do da'wah. Brothers, get excited to do da'wah with girls. Brothers, have some limitations. There are alhamdulillah great sisters who are in this field of da'wah. Let them do their job, you do your job. Next, brothers and sisters, I request you, by Allah I request you, do not neglect your family through this. Do not neglect your family through the smartphones, because of the smartphones. Next, don't spend so much of time. If you really want to spend some time, before going home, take half an hour off. Spend half an hour with it, updating yourself, updating your status, updating whatever you want. When you go back home, make sure that you are free from this. Next, do not use it to spread communal violence, communal hatred. Subhanallah. Use it to spread correct information. Use it to spread the right information. And there are many things that you and I can do, brothers, but it only comes down to what? Subhanallah. The opening ayat that I wanted to, that I started my talk. And in conclusion, brothers, I just want to leave you with few words. That phones have become so smart. Phones have become so smart. But if you actually look back how smart they've become, they've replaced your telephones. They've replaced your cameras. They've replaced your handy cams. They've replaced your watches. They've replaced your personal diaries. They've replaced your photo albums. Whatever you do, they've replaced it. Brothers and sisters, don't let them get so smart that they replace your happiness and your family. Subhanallah. There will come a time that your happiness and your family will be replaced by it. With that, I conclude with the opening verse that I started my talk, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَلْحَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَهَ مَنْ زَكَّهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّهَا. Allah has shown two paths, the path of taqwa, the path of sins, the path of righteousness, the path of filth. Allah has showed us, and you are standing at a fork. Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَهَ مَنْ زَكَّهَا. Whoever chooses the path of righteousness, the path of success, will be successful. Whoever chooses the path of destruction, the path of filth, will be destroyed. I leave you with a question, brothers and sisters. What are you going to choose with the path? What path are you going to choose with your smartphones? The path of success or the path of destruction? Subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa allahu akbar wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi illa al-azim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. يا الله يا كريم يا غفور يا رحيم. We ask you for the goodness of this life, يا الله. We ask you for the goodness of the hereafter, يا الله. يا الله, we ask you for knowledge that benefits us, يا الله. يا الله, we ask you for technology that benefits, يا الله. Ya Allah, we remember a dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-ilma an-nafi'a. Ya Allah, we ask you for ilm that benefits us, Ya Allah. We ask you for knowledge that makes us better Muslims, Ya Allah. We ask you for ilm that keeps away from sins, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, open the doors of your mercy towards us, Ya Allah. Towards our family members, Ya Allah. Towards the Muslim nations, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, we ask you for the admittance into Jannah and protection against Jahannam, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, when we are laid into our grave, Ya Allah, keep nur, keep make space in our grave, Ya Allah, and help us to answer our questions. اُتْلُ مَا أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ صَلَاةَ تَنْحَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ